Hey everybody, Ryan Marrinan here for 3M. Today we're going to talk a little bit about how to replicate a door skin bead, particularly here on this Chevy Malibu. Chevy on this particular model has a little bit higher profile bead, and we're going to show you how to replicate that using our products. Let's head inside and get started. All right guys, so let's get to our panel and show you how we're gonna replicate this bead. So what we've done here is we've got our epoxy primer down. We had some bare exposed metal. We wanna make sure we got covered up. I've also taped off the bead width that we're trying to go for here. And again, with the GM bead, it's a little bit taller, a little bit narrower. So I've taped it off kind of narrow here. It's going to have just a little bit drop. It'll widen out as it starts to settle down. So once we got it taped off, the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna grab our applicator and we're gonna equalize our cartridge. For this application, we're using 5887. And like with all of our cartridges, we want to make sure that we're equalizing them upward, preferably into a paper towel. And we want to make sure that we got equal parts of A and B that are being dispensed from the cartridge. Once it's been equalized and we've got our lock ring put back on our nozzle, we want to dispense a little bit of material out onto the mixing board. If you don't have a mixing board, you could do this in a paper towel as well. We just want to make sure that we're getting equal parts mixed as it's going down that static mixing nozzle. And typically we're going to run out about 2 inches, maybe 3 inches of material, just assuring that the product not only looks good, but is mixed. So let's get started. So what we want to do here is we want to be able to apply the seam sealer right over the top of that hem flange. And don't worry about being perfect with it. We're going to come back in here and we're going to fix this. But as I'm dispensing this, I want you to notice that I'm actually pushing the material inward towards that flange, making sure that the material is being forced onto the surface and along that seam so we got a nice tight seal so we got proper corrosion resistance. Next thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna take a spreader. I like to trim them down, so this is like a third of the size of a regular spreader. And we're just gonna knock down that surface. And all we're looking to do here is just get the material so that it goes tape to tape. Because again, the tape is actually the width of the bead that we're trying to replicate. Once we've done that, we're gonna go ahead and apply another bead over the top of this. Now it's important to point out, our best practice is that when you're doing this on a new panel, whether it be a door, deck lid, hood, that we start from one place each time as we go through the process. This is a good habit to get in. So when I taped it, I started from the same corner that I started the material from. And I've actually dog-eared my tape so that when I'm ready to pull it, that it's easier to pull off. When I dispense my material, I start from that same spot. When I knock it down, I start it from the same spot. And when I come back again to apply another bead over the top of this, I go back to the same spot. This way, the material has a consistent amount of time to sit, so you got a nice, even look all the way around the panel. So once we got around to the other side, I'll come back again after I've knocked it down, and we're gonna apply another bead right over the top. With this material, being that it acts like a high build control flow seam sealer, this is going to melt nicely into the surface below because again, we're still within the working window of both beads that we're applying. So the lower bead is still not reached maximum working time. And obviously the bead that we're applying and dispensing over the top is still in that same window. Now you see here as this bead starts to kind of sort of melt in, we're getting the look that we're already wanting to achieve. Now, as we make it all the way around to the other side of the panel, once we're done, we're gonna come back again to where we started and we're gonna pull our tape. Now it's important to point out when we pull our tape, we wanna make sure we're pulling backwards against itself or inward a little bit. This is the case with all of our seam sealers because we wanna make sure that we're not accidentally making a little bit of a ledge or a tidal wave off the edge of the seam sealer, making it difficult for the painter to get material in there to ensure that we've got a full corrosion resistant repair once the vehicle's been painted. So let's get started with pulling our tape off. And again, we're gonna pull it back against itself. And as we get to the corner, we're gonna kind of roll it around. And again, we're gonna just use that tape sort of as a knife edge to create a nice clean cut. And that's it. As long as you get your tape off, as soon as you're done spreading it, you're still within the working window. The material hasn't started setting up and these edges are gonna lay down flat and create a perfect tight seal. Now, one of the other things that you're gonna wanna do while you're still within the working window is come in here and we're gonna pinch off these corners. In some of the repair procedures, they'll actually tell you how far in or how much they want you to pinch off. So some of them might be a little bit further in, some of them might be shallow. But the reason that they do this is so that when the door's back up in a vertical position, water doesn't build up along that edge. We need to have a place for the water to drain out that might build up along the edge of that seam sealer. That way we're not trapping it there and we're damaging the surfaces of our finish while the vehicle's being parked. All right, guys, that's it for this panel here today. If you want more information about this or any of our other seam sealers, please visit 3M Collision Repair Academy. The link for that is in the description below. Also, check out some of the other videos on our page here as well. If you click the subscribe button down below and the notification bell in the corner, that'll keep you up to date as we're releasing new information so that you're staying ahead of the industry trends and up to date on the best practices. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, throw a comment in the section down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.